Ένα από τα μεγαλύτερα σύγχρονα λογοτεχνικά σκάνδαλα αφηγείται η ταινία «Η πιο μεγάλη απάτη» που θα κάνει πρεμιέρα σε λίγες μέρες στις ελληνικές αίθουσες. Είναι η πραγματική ιστορία μιας συγγραφέως που έγραφε με το ψευδώνυμο ενός δίθεν νεαρού ομοφιλόφιλου ονόματι J.T. LeRoy. Όταν το βιβλίο της έγινε best seller, σκέφτηκε μία αλόκοτη λύση για να διατηρήσει την ανωνυμία της.
Every time you come back from being JT, you're a mess.
I'm writing a piece about Savannah, who looks strikingly like Mr. LeRoy.
I've done a lot of, you know, films, and even short films before features, dealing with people and their kind of like shifting identity, whether they want to be someone else or be perceived as someone else. And then this one, to me, you know, it's the biggest version of the story because it's two people who literally pretend to be someone else. Mm-hmm. And people believe it. So I love these kinds of stories.
You're as much a part of JT as me.
I just wanted to tell you how much your work means to me.
It's super real for some people, you know?
Untangled finally.
She doesn't want you. She wants the rights to the movie.
Well, I think it's because, you know, since the movie is, you know, it's really about two women kind of finding their place in this world while pretending to be someone else. That's such a bizarre, interesting idea. Since it's about that, the issues surrounding gender are kind of like already there. You know, we see what's happening with Savannah as she's kind of, you know, binding her breasts to become more boyish, and we see that she enjoys that. And so I think it's about kind of like just letting the gender issues organically play out instead of trying to really highlight them.
Please tell me you are who you say you are.
Understand media.